Hey guys, in this video we're going to take a look at the Reloaded OS, which is based on Android 14 for our Nothing Phone 1. So let's take a look. So guys, starting with the boot animation, this is how it looks, and it looks like our device is going into some other mode, and I don't know, it's kind of a very old style of boot animation, and it will give you a feel of if you use Cyanogen mod and all that. I mean, not that exactly, but yeah, it's kind of old. Like, all the new animations are like snappy and they have that cool animations, all the new boot animations with the material design, but this one is kind of going into that old short and small one, not so funky and all, just that Android logo dropping the loading dots. So that's very cool and different. So guys, this is the home screen, and as you can see, it looks nice. The wallpaper, with all that dark blue, white and blue shades, and looks like it is just a paint thrown on a wall, and all that fluidity of the colors, and it looks really nice. And as you can see, this is the app drawer, the dock, and this is the app drawer, and we have all the Google apps. We also do have the Nothing camera, so let's take a look at it first. And it is fully functional, video, slow-mo, everything works fine. You can take into photo, portrait mode. You also have other modes, panorama, micro. So yeah, the Nothing camera works fine. Then we do have all the Google apps, and guys, this gapps only variant, so there's no vanilla variant. So if you want to install this ROM, you have to stick with gapps. So if you're a non-Google user, then this is not for you. Like, a lot of other ROMs are also coming, so stay tuned for that. But yeah, the ReloadedOS is not for you right now. So guys, now let's go into settings about phone. And as you can see, this is the ReloadedOS version 14, Android version 14. And it comes with the May security patch. And the June patch version is not yet released. It will be released soon, as you can see, official variant. So this is the official build type and gapps variant. And yeah, this is the device maintainer. Thanks to him for this nice and snappy ROM. Now guys, let's take a look at the features it offers. So first feature is Dolby Atmos, and it comes pre-installed, so you don't have to install any, and it works flawlessly. I've tried it with my Bluetooth earbuds, so it works fine with that. And you can also try it with the wired ones. I don't have the wired right now with me, or I would have tried it, but yeah, you can try with the wired ones too. Now into settings, go down here. You have the Reloaded extras. We don't get a lot of stuff here, just some basic stuff. So first is the icon manager. You can also manage and disable and enable icons. Then we have into quick settings. You have the quick settings pull down. So if you pull it from the left, you get only the notification and the first four quick settings. But if you pull it from the right, I don't know why that happened. Okay, so it's from the extreme right of your screen. Let's see if you pull it from here, pull it from the middle here. So if you pull it, I don't know why it is not working like that. Maybe, if I touch it here. Yeah, if you do it from the extreme right, you will directly open the quick setting. It's not that of a, that's of a hassle. You can easily pull it down like that, and everyone has that habit of doing that. Then show data usage. This is a handy feature. If you're looking how much data you have used today, then you can easily check with that feature. And it is, I think, a combined usage of Wi-Fi and your mobile data. Then the buttons, quick touch is a cool handy feature if you're going for traveling or something. So turn off your device screen, and you can use that function. You can use it to enable and disable. Then playback control, if you're using music or if you want to skip tracks, then you can easily do that when the device screen is off. You can use volume buttons to, skip tracks. That's a good feature, but I do not use it still because I just prefer the earbuds. And then we have here unlock higher FPS, some miscellaneous settings if you are really interested in gaming and doing other stuff. Then here into system, we have glyph interface. The glyph interface is also working fine. You can control the brightness. Control the brightness. You have the call animation. You have the pattern coded. So yeah, you have a lot of patterns. I thought it will show you a preview. Yeah, I don't use the glyph a lot, but yeah, when I do, I use a music visualizer when the room is completely dark, and it will give you a disco feel. So yeah, if you're alone and if you have to feel the disco vibes, then yeah, you can do that, like if you are weird like me. Then moving into battery usage, battery, you have the battery usage, battery percentage. Don't have the adaptive battery. I don't know why it is not there, but yeah, it's a handy thing from Google. And yep, that is it. Into display, not much. Again, the same icon manager setting here. Into colors, we have this modes. You can also, you know, you can check the RGB, change the RGB, refresh rate. We also have adaptive refresh rate. So the screen will adapt automatically according to the conditions. Also, we have display white balance. Yeah, I don't know what that is. Like for someone who needs a white balance, you can just check that. Full screen apps is also present. Like this is missing from a lot of, you know, things. A lot of ROMs. LineageOS supports that by default. So yeah, I think this is Lineage based, or I don't know. But it is totally snappy and really nice to use. I've been using this from like past 3 to 4 days, and it is really a nice job done by the developer of this ROM. And I hope they add a lot of features and customizations into it. Like, not that a lot, but yeah, the handy ones which we need. By the way, this is like the complete ROM for NothingOS. This is a new one. So please support them, and please, you know, offer your best review towards the ROM like I did. So yep, that is it for the video. If you really like this video, press the like button. If not, press the dislike button. And yes, also a like button for Nothing Phone 1 and this case, which is, I don't know, been with me for a long time using the Nothing Phone 1. So yeah, that's it. If you want to check the installation, you can check the further part of the video, or else this is the end. So let's move directly to the installation. For that, you have to power off the device. So first, I will power it off. Also guys, don't forget to enable USB debugging. So yeah, that's important. Now guys, let's take a look at the installation. Now first thing, these are the instructions on the screen. ReloadedOS instructions, installation instructions. So if you are that core flasher, you can easily jump right into it. You don't have to follow. Like, it's an easy peasy installation process. So first of all, you have to power your device into recovery mode, the stock recovery. So going to recovery mode like this, connect your device with the PC, plug your USB to the USB port. Okay, I have to tell you the instructions. So okay, when you visit here, enter fastboot. Just wait, we are into fastboot. Yeah, just place the device aside. Now to download the ROM, you have to visit this page. Sorry for that. You have to visit this page, the ReloadedOS page, and here you will have your build. So yeah, you have to download this build. Sorry for this blur. Wait, let me use this to focus. Yeah, this is the build you have to download. Now you have to go to the page you were in. Just yeah, just something I was trying earlier. Oh, okay. Now you have to start CMD. Ha ha ha! That's nice. I don't even know what's happening with my hand. So yeah, go into the CMD folder. Platform tools folder. Let me get this in the middle so that it will focus fine. Why is it not focusing? Yeah, that's fine. Now enter these commands. So first of all, you have to wipe your data. So fastboot w. okay, so it is the format is finished. And yes guys, backuping is important. Sorry about this. Okay, now you have to just copy this command. This command is for this specific 7 June build, fastboot update, and let the process end, and it will obviously reboot your device into the ReloadedOS. So yes, just set up and enjoy. And also press the like button if you have liked this video. If not, press the dislike button. Also show all your feedback in the comment section. And yes, you can give suggestions on what next video which I have to make. We have ReloadedOS, but the build which I tried of ReloadedOS was very laggy. So I don't know how to share it with you guys. So yeah, let's see. After this, we will review the ReloadedOS if there's a new build released. Or we'll wait for the lag to get fixed, only then I can share it with you guys. Or yeah, I like a lot of you have already tried that ROM, because that is very it's quick spreading, it's very famous because of the user interface and the customizations it offers. So yeah, let's see what happens. And yeah, let's skip this part where the installation should finish. So guys, the installation has been finished. Now you just have to get back to your device and reboot system. That is it. So that's it for the ReloadedOS review and installation. If you guys really love this video, then press the like button. If not, the dislike button. Also, you can subscribe for more stuff. And I think this is done. So bye bye.